This video explains how a pressure transmitter works. To understand this, let's first take a closer look at the two key elements. The first key element is the pressure sensor. It detects the media pressure and converts it into an electrical signal. The other important element is the chip. It is needed to convert the generated electrical signal into a normalized output signal. Let's first take a closer look at the function of the pressure sensor. The pressure sensor is a thin film on steel cell. This means that the resistance bridges are applied as a thin film to a steel measuring cell. The thin film is only a few atomic layers thick. In a cross-section, the pressure sensor looks like this. If pressure is applied to the pressure sensor, its membrane deforms at predefined points. The resistors are placed exactly at these points. The resistors change their value when they are stretched or compressed. On the measuring cell, we have four strain resistors. Two resistors each form a path, left and right. A bridge can be formed in the middle, where the voltage can be measured. This bridge is called a Wheatstone bridge. When there is no pressure, all resistors have the same value, and thus there is no voltage between the two paths on the left and right. When the pressure deforms the membrane, two resistors are compressed and two resistors are stretched. This increases the electrical resistance in the stretched areas. In the compressed areas, on the other hand, the pressure decreases. This changes the condition on the resistance bridge. Or, in other words, a signal is generated. But the measured signal is not linear. Moreover, the measured signal varies depending on the temperature. This is because the temperature has a strong influence on the resistances of the bridge. How do you obtain a linear, accurate, and temperature-independent measurement signal from the measured signal? With the electronics, the measurement signal is corrected and also amplified. For example, a 10 millivolt signal becomes a 10 volt signal. This is where the second key component for the functioning of the pressure transmitter comes into play, namely the ASIC. The correction values are stored in the ASIC, the application-specific microchip. These values are determined and stored individually for each pressure transmitter. To determine the correction values, a precisely defined pressure is applied to the ready-mounted pressure transmitter, and the signal is measured. From this, the correction values for the pressure can be calculated. Subsequently, the process is repeated at different temperatures. This allows the correction values for the temperature compensation to be determined. The correction values determined in this way are then calculated and stored in the chip. In this way, a linear and standardized measurement signal can be generated from the raw signal of the measuring cell, and this over the entire pressure and temperature range. This standardized measurement signal can be transmitted to higher level controls. Let's take a closer look at the ASIC, the application-specific integrated circuit. On an area of about 2.5 by 2.5 millimeters, the chip houses millions of circuits in the smaller structures. The small silver balls are soldering points that establish contact between the chip and the electronics of the pressure transmitter. This fine structure is only visible under the microscope. However, even at this minuscule scale, you will be able to find the Trafag logo carefully engraved in fine detail on the circuit board. It is about 100 micrometers in height. The best results are obtained when the measuring cell and the microchip are precisely matched. Trafag therefore produces its own measuring cells and has developed its own ASIC. By developing the two key components under one roof, the best quality and reliability can be guaranteed. You can count on that.